These are.
Was a famous trumpet man from out Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was a top man at his craft. But then his number came up and he was gone with the draft. He's in the army now, a blowing reveille. He's a boogie boogie bugle boy of Company B. They made him blow a bugle for his Uncle Sam. It really brought him down because he couldn't jam. The cap seemed to understand. Because the next day the cap went out and drafted a band. And now the company jumps.
My favorite thing about performing other people, I love communicating. It's nice to communicate with people.
Yeah.
It's a very uplifting thing. And I feel as if I had to share. I just can't just play for myself. I feel as if I have to. I'm trying to just do something to make people feel good about themselves and about me, I guess, and everything, you know, about life. Because life is so wonderful, isn't it?
Your daddy's all alone. I have tried in vain, never no more to call your rotten, stinking old name. Since I left you, broke my heart, 'cause I thought that we would never part. Each hour of each day, you can hear me say, baby, won't you please come home to your papa? Baby, won't you please come home? I'm gonna play them.
Well, I used to run dances in Hudson County in the 60s. Very successful. And of course, I was really the band. And besides running the dances, my main reason was we were providing music. And in the summertime, we'd go down the Jersey Shore and we'd play and we'd get to all kinds of, you know, kids and girls and guys and come up to these dances. But of course, like most musicians, you do something for a while and then you sort of went around. You change venues. And one day I got a phone call from one of my friends who used to help us with the dance, and he said, Bobby, I hear you're cutting out the dancers. I said, well, yeah, Red, I'm going to cut them out, got something else going, I'm going to be playing, do maybe some traveling. Says, oh no, you can't cut them out. The boys want them to continue. Now the boys meant, holy moly, big men in Union City who ran the whole Hudson County. I said, well, tell the boys that I'm going to do it. Well, he hesitated, called me back and said, I discussed it with the boys. The boys said they would like your mailing list. I said, well, Red, that's my own private property. Bobby, The mailing list is no longer your private property. It belongs to the boys, and we want it. We'll run our own dances. So what I was damned if I was going to give my mailing list, but he threatened me. He said, if you don't do it, there will be results. You know, there was very, very fancy language, but I knew what they were talking about. So what I did, I went to the phone book, different phone books from New York and different areas, because we used to get crowds from Westchester and everything. And I just put bogus names on it. I made up an enormous list. And I gave them the list, and then they were satisfied, and they ran their dances, and the dances were a flop. And the good thing was, boy, see, without Bob Livy, nobody comes.
Somebody stole my gal. Somebody stole my pal. Somebody came and took her away. She didn't even her kisses I love so. La 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 la. Oh yeah.
Used to play the piano and sing, and they used to come over to my house and play the piano, and have gatherings, and everybody would sing and play. And one day, my father had an old cornet laying around, and I saw it there, and I just picked that up and started playing with them. I didn't know what I was doing, but it worked. The notes fit, and ever since then, I've been playing trumpet. The nice thing was, in retrospect, when you think back, they sort of stopped playing for a minute, and my uncle smiled, and they continued playing. And they didn't say anything, like, oh, isn't that wonderful? You know, all that junk that people say. Instead, I was now one of the boys, and when they sang songs, I could play the trumpet with them.
Yes, sir.
Why? And I thought that was so nice. I didn't realize it then, but I realize it now.
Yeah.
You know, and then I took lessons, and eventually I went to Weehawken High School, and was always in trouble and suspended every other week, and terribly, because Weehawken is right by the Hudson River. And in those days, we had these big ferries coming across for a nickel a ferry. And in the high school, I would go out for lunch, and I'd eat up by the boulevard and overlook the Hudson, and I'd see those ferries going. So guess what, baby? I never came back for lunch, you see. So, of course, I was never in school. I was persona. Never there, put it that way. So, that's weird. It took me a while to get out of high school, but I accomplished it.
How you doing?
Oh, I'm doing great.
I've seen you since last week.
That's right. I was here for a while.
But I mean, I seen you know you played back. It was wonderful.
Yeah. Oh, thanks.
You guys have been going to what the kid was doing here last week. I can't believe it. I've heard about it.
Yeah, but what we need is a group like you to back us up.
Oh,
and then we do a show all together. You know what I mean?
Oh, I would love that.
Like the old days, remember?
Yes. Yeah. There's real tap dancing. This is the real thing. Yeah. And there's another famous woman that comes in, and I can't think of her name, and she's so wonderful. And then they have these young kids, all ages, teenagers, and they're good, I'm telling you. These kids are wonderful.
Really? He's a tap dancer, that guy?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. He looks like he's having a little trouble.
The old school, you know.
It's really old school, yeah.